You know, I don't know how many of you, my teammates or people here who are watching this actually watched my summer challenge, but I kind of talked a lot about a gentleman who kind of came into my life, I mean, not really on a personal level, only on a professional level, but who has had nothing but bad things happen to him. And every time he comes in, he brings a smile to my face. As a matter of fact, last week he came right up to my office like, "Am I bothering you?" I'm like, "You're never bothering me. Come and have a seat." And we were talking a little bit more about his life and some of the things that were, you know, some of the things that he had to overcome because that's my job. But again, he was incredibly happy. And I'm like, and I said, "You know, I've been preaching that forever. How do you do that?" And he said to me, "What is the point? What is the point of sitting there and dwelling on the things that are bad in your life when there's so many things in our life that are good? Focus on the positive."
What about the keeping right here? Is it worth it? It's exclusive, baby. Let's run it.
All right, so I'm going to get right down to business. I have a few things on your plate for this week, or for the weeks to come, actually. And they're not like physical challenges and all these things. Of course, some of the things I do for your mind. But firstly, I want you to proactively, as soon as you see this video, seek out your accountability buddy teams, your new folks that are out there. Shoot them an email via YouTube if they don't have instant messenger. Instant message them right away. And we're going to do the same things that we were going to do, kind of report to each other, although I know some of us were a lot more gung-ho about it and really took this to heart than others. There's a new little task that I have as a part of an accountability buddy team, a new accountability buddy team member duty. And that is, as all of you know, I say your videos are due by Wednesday. You got 1, 2, 3, 4 days to put up your video so everybody can watch every video. So that first duty is, if your accountability buddy teammate has not had a video up, it is time to unleash the accountability buddy demons. I mean, unleash the accountability buddies to you can flood their inbox saying, "Where the heck are you? Where's your video? What's going on?" Because you know what? I'm not micromanaging you guys. I want leaders of my group to come out of the woodwork. And I know you are all capable of it. So, of course, I am still going to be wondering where people are. We have a few people who haven't even done a video yet. I still included them in the accountability buddy teams. And a couple people did actually reach out to me and said, "You know what, Greg, I can't make a video this week. There's going to be one coming next week." So at least they let me know that they're alive, they're still going strong and all that stuff. They just didn't have a video camera available or whatever. I don't know, but it's important. You stick on each other. Your other task, one thing that I really wanted to see with this challenge is more of a lot of feedback, a lot of interaction. And though some of you are doing it on Messenger, and it's only some of you, I'm looking at a lot of videos, and not just on this team, on every team. And some people are very diligent about not just leaving comments, but leaving good feedback on each video that they watch. And other people aren't leaving comments at all. It's one of the reasons why I made these groups smaller is so that we all have a chance to watch everybody, give them some good feedback. So I want you to challenge yourself to be able to, and that's the reason why I give you four days to put up your videos, so you have a good amount of days. I watch maybe 5 videos a day, maybe 6 or 7 on some days, but I get through every single video in my team because I space it out like that. It works. And I make sure that I have something instructive to say to everybody. And that's what I'm charging you to do, because that is the biggest reason we're here. It's not for me to tell you what to do, because I am not the magic wizard of weight loss who can wave my wand your way and just say, "Here's what you got to do." This is more about you, but it's also more about community. So I want you to do that. And really, I mean, charge yourself to do that. I mean, make that a commitment to yourself. You know what I do when I watch videos? I work out. I watch a video, I do a set of push-ups. I watch a video, I do a set of push-ups. I watch a video, I do a set of push-ups. Before I know it, I have about 100 push-ups done, and my arms feel awesome. I mean, awesome. So, anyway, just something to think about. Kind of the mind challenge, or my thought of the day, comes back to where we began this video with, is, and I've seen a lot of people every day of my life in person on YouTube, they take a situation they take a person that they're just meeting, and it's human. We want to just look, seek out the bad in it. what is wrong with what's going on around me, instead of, let's say, looking for what's right. And that's what I challenge you to do, to consciously make an effort to always find what's good in the situation, what's good in the person, what's good in this challenge. As you can see, there's a lot of good in this challenge. Instead of trying to single out what's bad. Do it every day for the next 3 weeks, and you're going to find yourself starting to do it all. And the reason why I say this is big is if you look at people in this world who are successful, and I'm not just talking about in weight loss, who are constantly successful, is that they're positive about everything. They seek out the good in everybody. They don't look search out the bads just so they can bitch about it later. Just a thought. Anyway, how did I do this week? Exactly the same as last week. I actually don't have footage, but I don't have to. You can just trust me. I lost another 0.4 pounds, and I am going to continue to do what I did last week this week, except for up the intensity of my workout a little bit more. And if I have to me, 0.4 loss, even though it's a loss, is kind of a plateau because my body is capable of losing faster. So I'm going to shake up my routine if I have three straight weeks of this like 0.4-ish loss, because my first 2 weeks I had, 6.4 and 4.6. So just want to let you know that. Other than that, I don't want this video to be too long. You kind of have my feelings about where we're going with this thing. If you have any questions, please contact me, especially my teammates. And that challenge that I have, the mind challenge, seek out the good, it's not just for my team. It's for the world. Do it, and life gets easier, and you smile more. Have a great one.